What's going on, everybody? Gareth here, FCP Euro. Welcome back to another DIY video. Today, we're replacing spark plugs on an E92 M3 on the lift behind us. Spark plugs are a very common maintenance item on any vehicle that is not a diesel. Simply put, it is a wear item. You're gonna have to replace them. Worn spark plugs are going to cause misfires and a variety of other problems, but on a high performance application such as an E9X M3 with the S65 V8, spark plugs are more than just for combusting fuel. These also act as a knock sensor, believe it or not. There's a whole ionic current detection system in the DME, and it's a very complicated thing, but it's more than just a spark plug. That said, BMW's recommendation on this is 37,500 miles. This car has had spark plugs replaced once in its past, has a little bit over 50,000 miles at this point, so this is not gonna be the second time these spark plugs are being replaced. We're gonna take you along for the ride today. That said, let's talk about some of the tools we're gonna do this job. I'll go ahead and jump right into it. So some of the tools you're gonna need to do this job, various sized ratchets, handle lengths, flex head. There's very little space towards the rear of the engine bay on this car, so you're gonna have to make it work, basically. To that end, you'll need a 10 millimeter socket, a T25 and a T20 Torx, various lens extensions. You will need some kind of pry tool, whether it be a flathead screwdriver or a pry bar. The ignition coils are very difficult to get off of the valve cover. Pop rivet pliers, and particularly a 5/8 flexible spark plug socket like this with a magnetic holder. That is going to be your saving grace on this job. And optionally, there's the spark plug installation tool that we sell from BMW. Super useful for getting the spark plugs threaded. And you will need a torque wrench that can do 23 newton meters of torque. So with that said, these are the tools that you need to do the job. Let's go ahead and jump right into it. So I'm gonna start off by doing what we need to do to get the air box out of the way. And I'm gonna start right up here with the suction hood. Two T20 screws. Secure this to the radiator support. So I'm gonna remove these. And then we have these little expanding rivets. Just using these pliers to pull the center section up. This whole forward section will slide forward. And then we have the rearward section, which will simply pull back and slide off, like so. And now we have eight T25 screws that secure the airbox cover to the bottom of the airbox. All right, so at this point, this has a inventory cold air intake on it. Most of this procedure has been the same up to this point. The only place where this could be different is these hose clamps here. It's a 7 millimeter drive for the inventory setup. It might be 6 for the factory clamp. I don't really remember off the top of my head. But either way, we're gonna loosen this clamp. And then on your factory airbox, the filter is supported by a spring-loaded mechanism here. So you'd have to pull that plunger forward and then pull the entire piece out in one section. You know, obviously if you have a different intake on your car, that's gonna be different. And now to remove the rest of the air box, we have two 10 millimeter screws that secure it to the body. So I'm gonna start with the left cylinder bank. This is bank 2, so cylinders 5 through 8. We'll do each side independently because they have their own sort of constraints. You'll notice that the engine cover or this ignition coil cover on this side, our fuel feed line is connected to it. So we're gonna have to pull this up and out of it, like so. We also have our secondary air pump fresh air hose that runs in the back. So that kind of hinders us a little bit. These are just held in place by some grommets. So you're gonna pull up evenly, like so, and then you have to snake it forward, like so. And these are the grommets that secure the valve cover, or this little ignition coil cover, to the valve cover. So it secures here and back there. All right, so next up, we're going to disconnect our ignition coils. Simply push down on the little release here and they should slide off fairly easily. If they're not, you could use a little pry bar to slide them back. However, I can't say, at least on these engines, I've ever had an issue with these connectors coming off. So these ignition coils do not come out very easily on this engine. BMW has a special puller tool just for these, and you don't need it, but these ignition coils are very expensive. You do not want to break one. So this is where I said, you know, the puller is not necessary. Now I wish I had the $280 special tool from BMW because it would save some time. But what I'm gonna do is flathead screwdriver right through here. And as I'm pulling up on this, I'm also gonna pull from the coil itself. There we go. Just as like a little extra, she needs a little extra encouragement. But yeah, these things are super, super tight on the spark plug. It's not really here where you have the problem, it's down there. So just finding a place to safely pry from, you just need to get these things moving. You do risk breaking that off or tweaking it sideways, so you really wanna be careful. Just gonna use a little bit of compressed air to blow any kind of debris that could be inside the spark plug wells out. It's not a bad practice to use some compressed air to blow debris that could be stuck inside the spark plug wells out. Say, given how tight these ignition coils seal, it's probably not going to be a problem. But if you did have one of the spark plug tube seals leaking some oil, you don't want to open up the engine, have that oil drip into the cylinder, because if there's enough, and let's just say it was in the compression stroke, you could potentially hydrolock the engine that way. So just, it's never a bad idea to just blow a little bit of compressed air and remove that possibility. Just one extra step, it's not a big deal. Better to play it safe. I'm using a standard 5/8 spark plug socket. So I'm using this spark plug installation tool. It's basically just a piece of rubber that's going to allow me to get the spark plug down inside the well and get it started by hand. Torque spec on these spark plugs is 23 newton meters. So for our right bank, or bank one, cylinders 1 through 4, we need to pull our expansion tank forward. And we have two 10 millimeter screws that secure the tank in location. There's a couple of grommets that secure the tank in place. But you can basically pull this whole thing forward. Just be really careful with this line underneath and the return line here. You can get quite a bit of angle on these things and really work it forward so that it is completely out of the way. So we do have a level sensor here. We'll want to disconnect it. And if you have a good expansion tank and good connections, it won't leak coolant all over the place. So now we need to remove the ignition coil cover here. Same thing as the other side, just held in with a couple of grommets. So pull up and slide this forward. Again, would not be able to do that if you left the expansion tank in the way, plus it frees up a lot of space. Similar process here. I'm gonna use any pry point available and get the coils moving. Once they're moving, they fairly come out, you know, reasonably easy, but not really. You just gotta break that initial seal. So before we get into it, we're just gonna blow the spark plug holes out again. And yeah, we're gonna do the same procedure here where we start in the rear. So at this point, we need to reinstall the ignition coils. I'm gonna start at the back of the engine because that is by far the worst. And then we will work our way towards the front, so. So at this point, I did start the car briefly, no misfires. Really important to make sure those ignition coils are seated. And then once you have confirmed that they are seated by the car running and not misfiring, we are going to reinstall our ignition coil covers. So those go push in the grommets like so. And then you have a little holder there for that. And then after that, we can reposition our expansion tank. There's a little stud that has to sit in a grommet, and then once that's in place, we'll reinstall the two 10 millimeter screws. All right, we'll drop the base of our airbox in. So that's how you change the spark plugs on an E9X M3, 2008-2013, or any S65 V8. You probably noticed that the valve covers changed color during this DIY. That's because we were doing other work simultaneously. There's another video on the NRW design valve covers, which we'll drop a card for you to see that. Worth upgrade on this car for sure. Hope you learned a lot. If you have any questions or comments, leave them in the comment box below. If you'd like this video, hit the like button. Of course, you want to hit subscribe. We have a lot of videos on the way. And as always, we'll see you for the next one. Thanks for watching.